We are inside of a cultural route called Trip to the Time of the Iberos. The Iberian culture starts on the 7th century before Christ until the 1st century before Christ. During the Roman Republic, still the Iberian culture is still very strong and autonomous. Starting with Augustus, all the imperial strengths of Rome started to crush definitively the Iberian culture.
Lo que tenemos aquí delante es un oppidum, que es la ciudad ibérica.
We have an what we have in front of us is an oppidum, the Iberian city.
Es una ciudad fortificada de la que hay excavada una parte de la fortificación.
It's a fortified city which is already excavated part of the fortifications,
que tiene un origen en este caso del siglo IX antes de Cristo,
with an origin of the in the 9th century before Christ, with a nucleus of huts
que en el siglo VII se fortifica.
That is fortified during the 7th century. The fortification that we see up there lasts until the 3rd century before Christ.
Es muy importante, a partir del siglo VII constatamos el desarrollo de vid, olivo, árboles frutales. Por ejemplo, aquí es muy importante el almendro, la almendra. Un corredor de ancho de 4 metros. La puerta tiene como 14 metros.
Fertility.
Stone below is closing a box of stones. Several layers of offerings inside that box when it was excavated.
Ofrendas de cerdas femeninas embarazadas.
Of feminine pigs, pregnant feminine pigs. It's a very normal ritual associating a goddess with the equinoctial in the Phoenician
Y de hecho, la aparición del sol, dándole la luz o quitándole la luz a la diosa, nos permite pensar un dios que muere y que todos los años vuelve a aparecer y se encuentra con la diosa. Que pensamos que la diosa está dentro y fuera de la capilla en determinados momentos del año.
That's why it is believed that the goddess is changed alternatively from the outside to the inside of the chapel. The day the sun rises between this mountain and the highest one there, the sun, the first flash goes there to that, right to that point on the
Y eso nos hace pensar que es el momento en que la diosa, la estela, la sacan de la capilla,
so it's
y la
believed
colocan en
that that is the moment when the goddess is taken out of the chapel and placed here.
Lo que queda detrás es un santuario que estamos excavando ahora, es lo que teníamos que haber excavado y tenían que haber visto completo.
What is behind is a sanctuary that is still under an excavation. Till this excavation had been done, no other palace like this, no other palace in fact, not like this, but no other palace was new in Andalusia.
En realidad, para entenderlo,
there is an open area which is believed to be the sanctuary of their ancestors.
Tiene un es un patio abierto con una pequeña cela y un betilo. Un betilo es una piedra que representa la divinidad.
Okay, it's an open yard with a small small kind of cupboard, small re-entrance, and a stone, a betilo, where the divinities usually are put over.
Esta parte que queda con el muro más grueso,
living and for storing food.
Esta zona que queda
hacia la derecha, en toda esta parte de acá, son los servicios, la cocina, es decir, toda la área de servicios.
It's the area for
service.
Para hacer
el pan.
Kitchen and so on.
Este es el santuario. Esta parte estaría abierta, pero tendría una entrada desde fuera para que los clientes entraran a hacer sus ofrendas a los antepasados del príncipe.
That part should be open so that the clients could step into to make the offerings to the gods on this area.
Al fondo estaría la parte privada.
In the end, this is the private area that we referred with double wall.
It should be the kitchen area.
I see that. I see that.
Los elementos del calendario.
De las horas.
Claro. De los meses, de las horas.